Jennifer Lopez started performing professionally as a dancer, but she made a name for herself as an actress in the movies Selena and Out of Sight. And all the while, she had her sights set on singing too.
I know people got to know me first as an actress because I didn't even start recording my first album until Out of Sight, after Out of Sight came out. So that was kind of a weird thing. I think people were like, why is she doing this? But I just knew it was part of who I am, you know, and who I was. So it wasn't weird to me. And I knew that people would see that eventually.
The executives at a music label did.
They had heard my demo tape and I wanted to do it, and my manager set up the meeting, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, they're like, we'll give her a record deal for this much money. You know, and it was a really small deal and everything, and I was just like, I want to meet the head of the company.
That man was Tommy Mottola, chairman and CEO of Sony Music. The same Tommy Mottola who launched the careers of Mariah Carey and Celine Dion.
It happened to be in New York. It was around Christmas time. And I was getting my hair done with my mom at a salon a few blocks away from Sony, just so happened to be. And I get a call from my manager. He's like, Tommy Mottola can see you right now. And I was like, I can't see Tommy Mottola right now. I'm with my mother. We're getting our hair colored. And he's like, Jennifer. And even though I knew I wanted to meet the head of the company, I didn't, you know, see him as like Tommy Mottola. You know what I mean? This big guy who doesn't have that. I didn't see it as that. I was just like, no, I'll see him Monday. Tell them I can do it Monday. I can do it Monday or I can do it tomorrow, Saturday. You know what I mean? They're like, no, Jennifer, he's leaving for the Hamptons at 6 o'clock and you have to go now. And I'm like, I'm not going now. Please, come on. I want my mom. No, so my manager's like, I hung up. He called back. He's like, Jennifer, please, he can't change it. He's going to see you now or he doesn't see you at all. Because I guess he had heard the tape, heard my demo tape. I was just like, where is this girl? Let me talk to her. And used to, you know, having things like that, he's like, get her on the phone. And I was like, all right, fine, I'll go over there, give me the address, you know. And I go over there, ignorance being bliss, you know what I mean, and just going over there. I was like, you know what, I was getting my hair colored with my mom. My mom is in the other room. I brought her over here. And he's like looking at me like, who is this crazy girl, you know? And he's like, well, I heard your demo tape and I just want to know, what do you want? And I was like, what do I want? Oh, you know, and he closed the door, you know, he talked to me for like 2 minutes and then he closed the door and he's like, what do you want? And I was just like, I want, you know, an A-level deal. I want everything A all the way, you know what I mean? I want the right videos, I want this, I want the company to be behind me, I want a real deal. I don't want a little, you know, bullcrappy deal, you know, just like throw off and see what happens. I said, I want to know that I have the support of this company. And he was like, okay, well, we'll do that then. All right, so we have a done deal. And I was like, no. I said, you got to talk to my manager, because I didn't know anything about the music business at the time. I didn't know.
But that was
what
it.
That was pretty much it. The next few days, he called my manager right away. He's like, get her manager on the phone. I mean, that's how he is. He's like, when he wants something, he gets it done right away.
Jennifer went into the studio and started recording songs for her debut album On the Six, named after the subway line she used to take into Manhattan. The CD was released in June 1999, and its first single, If You Had My Love, went to number one. If you had my love and I gave you all my trust, would you comfort me? One of the tracks on the album, Feeling So Good, was brought to Jennifer by record producer Sean Puffy Combs. It wasn't long before Lopez and Combs were making music of their own.
How explosive did things get when you started dating Puffy? Because I felt like that's really when the media attention really started getting crazy. Mm-hmm.
I think that's when we started getting a lot of press, for sure. There was a big interest in us for some reason. And you never know, it's just a thing. Just people just all of a sudden, they're like, yep, let's write about them. So it was strange, but it was fine. You know, at that point, I was a little more used to it and had been in the press enough that I knew how to handle it and kind of take it with a grain of salt at that point. I think Puffy was very kind of like not liking it as much, but and would get very upset at certain things that they wrote and stuff, and he would be like, you have to care about this stuff. And I was like, I just don't. It's not true. Why should we care? Forget it. You know what I mean? That was more my attitude always. And that's just how I handled it.
Coming up on Revealed, the shots heard round the world.
It was a terrible time.
And later,
so you think you are a diva, but you're not a bitch.
As a couple, Jennifer Lopez and Sean Puffy Combs constantly made headlines. One night in December 1999, they made the crime log. Lopez and Combs were in a Manhattan nightclub when shots were fired. Three people were wounded. Minutes after the shooting, Jennifer and Puffy left the club and were pulled over by police. An unregistered gun was found in their car. Jennifer and Puffy were arrested on charges of criminal possession of a weapon.
How hard was the nightclub shooting?
It was tough. I mean, it was a terrible time, you know what I mean? Especially when you know you didn't do anything, you know what I mean? And then to become the center, especially for him, you know what I mean? And you just try to be supportive as you can, you know, and just keep praying that it's over quickly.
I want to say to you all face to face, I had nothing to do with a shooting that night in a nightclub. Absolutely nothing to do with the shooting that night in the nightclub, nor did Jennifer. We went there together by ourselves to have a good time in a limousine. And yes, she is doing well.
After being detained by police for more than 12 hours, Jennifer was cleared of all charges.
And you testified, didn't you?
Yeah, to the grand jury I did. That whole process is not fun. You know what I mean? Obviously, nobody really wants to be arrested or handcuffed or, you know, go through all that kind of stuff.
It was a scary thing to have happen to you, to be standing somewhere where bullets go past your head, you know. It was scary for her and stressful, I know, especially since she wasn't in trouble for anything, but you couldn't get away from the media coverage of how she was involved in the situation.
But again, something that I feel in my life that happened for a reason and to make me stronger and to let me know that I can get through anything. It doesn't matter what it is, that God is with me and that everything's going to be okay. And so long as I live my life in the right way, it doesn't matter how things are spun or what people say or what they think it is. So long as that I know I've done the right thing, that everything's going to be okay.
Jennifer refused to let the incident cramp her style. In fact, Jennifer's style was the topic of conversation at the 2000 Grammy Awards, thanks to a very revealing Versace dress. January 2001 was a big month for Jennifer Lopez. Her second album, J-Lo, reached the top of the Billboard charts, and she was starring in the country's number one movie, The Wedding Planner. Jennifer became the first performer to reach both milestones the same week.
I was doing a lot of press for like The Wedding Planner, and J-Lo, the record, was about to come out in the same week, and we did a blitz of press, and I was doing Saturday Night Live, and then I was about to start rehearsing for Enough, and then during Enough, I just kind of hit the wall and was just like, I can't do this anymore. I'm tired. I'm doing videos on the weekends and shooting the movie during the week and recording, and it was bananas. It was a really, really crazy time.
And Poppy was still in court.
What was it like for you to have so much success and then this other stuff going on?
It was like exactly what you would think it would be if you were going through it. It was like a mix of like highs and lows, you know what I mean? Where it was just like this incredible stuff was happening in my career, and I was trying to focus on that and work as hard as I could to make all that stuff work and be a success. And at the same time, you know that this part of your life is kind of coming to an end, and you know it's wrapping up, and there's all those emotions and separations, and it was a really tough time. It was a really, really tough time. And he was going through the trial at that time too, so it was a lot of stuff to deal with all at once. But again, I feel if I hadn't gone through that, I wouldn't be the person that I am today, who's much more sure of herself and much more kind of secure with the person that I am.
Ironically, on Valentine's Day 2001, Jennifer Lopez and Sean Puffy Combs officially split up.
What do you think about that relationship when you look back at it now?
Just like how you look back on any relationship, you know, it helps you grow and it helps you get to the next place, you know. When you're in it, you're hoping it becomes, you know, something great. And if it doesn't, then you move on, you know what I mean? You still have you care about that person as a human being. You spend 3 years of your life with them, or however long it is you spend with them. And then that's it, you know. I still care about him as a person, and we'll always be friends.
Coming up, a second trip down the aisle.
A lot more goes into a marriage than just love.
And later, third time's a charm, hopefully.
They're already trying to put little roadblocks.
By 2001, Jennifer Lopez was the highest paid Latina actress in Hollywood. She had hit records, a clothing line, and an empire in the making.
I love anything artistic, and all of those things happen to be very artistic. And so I feel I have something to offer because I have a point of view and I have a passion about it.
So you are so hands-on with everything, you can really focus.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's only so many hours in a day, and that's what I'm always trying to get people to understand, because when you're part of the clothing business or you're part of the fragrance business or you're part of the, you know, acting career, they all think that they're the only thing. And so it's like, look, I have only so many hours for this and this and this and this, and I have to be like really businesslike about it.
Jennifer Lopez, with all of her various enterprises, became known simply as J-Lo.
I didn't think that people would rename me J-Lo, you know what I mean? I like it. I named my album J-Lo, you know, because I like the fact that the fans actually nicknamed me that. But a nickname is not supposed to be your only name, you know what I mean? I miss Jennifer a little bit. You can call me Jennifer again, or Jenny, or J-Lo. It's fine. Anything is fine. But I really feel like, it's not that I don't like it. It's just that it really caught on. People call me it all the time. Well, I am Jennifer Lopez, and my mother has a real thing with the J-Lo thing. I'm sorry, J-Lo. You know what I mean? You know, like, Ma, don't call me J-Lo, all right? It's just the name of the album, Mommy. You know what I mean? And she's like, but now it's like the other person. It's not me. It's the other, you know, celebrity person.
I read a quote from you where you said that you admired Barbara Streisand, Diana Ross, Rita Moreno.
Mm-hmm.
That you really wanted to have careers like they had.
Mm-hmm.
Have.
Have. Exactly. That's the thing. They still have them. You know what I mean?
But all those women have been labeled as divas.
Yeah.
So here comes the question.
Yeah.
Are you a diva?
I mean, it's really how you want to use the word. I mean, I think a lot of times it's used in a negative way. You know what I mean? And why is it used in a negative way? Why is a woman who's successful and who has dreams and who's gone after it and who's made it happen and stuff like that have to be labeled in that way? And that diva thing to me says that you have bad behavior, which I don't have, which I don't feel I have. I don't treat anybody disrespectfully. I don't yell at people. I don't throw things across the room. I don't demand things. You know what I mean? I ask for things. I collaborate with people. I work hard. I'm a professional. I show up on time. That's the way I handle my business. So in that way, no, I don't think I'm a diva. But if it means, if you were to put me in a category, you know, with people that I have always aspired to have a career that is similar to theirs because they've sing and dance and act and have been able to maintain over many years, then, you know, yeah, put me in that category. Please, I hope one day I'm in that category.
But don't you think when people call people a diva, they're really saying she's a bitch?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. When it's used in a negative way, it's something that I don't feel that I should be associated with because I don't think it's fair.
So you think you are a diva, but you're not a bitch?
Yeah. I don't think that's what I said. But no, I'm not a bitch. No.
Jennifer will admit to being a hopeless romantic. Just 7 months after ending the relationship with Sean Combs, she married Chris Judd, a dancer who appeared with Jennifer on stage and in videos.
I'm choreographing two of her videos that are coming out, working on some other stuff, and it's going to be exciting. We're in rehearsal right now for her next video.
A lot more goes into a marriage than just love. I mean, I learned that in my first marriage, but in my second marriage, it became more abundantly clear.
After only 10 months, Lopez filed for divorce.
Things just don't work out sometimes. You have the best intentions going in. You feel like, you know, it's something that you want to be really great and special and last throughout time. But, you know, sometimes the world gets in the way, things happen. It just is not right, you know? It's not that either one person is bad or good or anything like that. You know, both people could be great people who love and care about each other a lot. We parted friends, and I wish him the best, and I know he wishes me the best, and he knows that he always has a friend here in me, and that's just, you know, it's life. It's another thing in life for me where I feel like you just grow, and you move on, and you try to handle the situations with honesty and integrity. And so long as you do that, you know, everything will be okay. God will smile on that. You know what I mean? Nobody's without mistakes. You're gonna make mistakes. Everybody does. You know, I'm not perfect, you know, and I don't claim to be. I'm just a human being like everybody else. And except that my mistakes and my things are like, you know, on the front page of the paper.
Before her second divorce was final, Jennifer was making headlines again with a new man.
Ben Affleck. What do you think when I say his name?
I love him, and I'm very happy we're together, and he's very happy, and we know that we're gonna be reported on, and everything we do is gonna be reported on.
I'm just looking at the ring. I can't help it.
It's beautiful.
Thank you. It is beautiful. This is a very beautiful ring.
More on the ring and the romance when we return.
In November 2002, Jennifer Lopez's life was a soap opera played out in the tabloids, the weekly magazines, and on the nightly news. Everyone wanted to know about Jennifer and her new beau, Ben Affleck. Ben made an appearance earlier in the year at the opening of Jennifer's restaurant, Madre's. First, there was the ring, a conspicuously large pink diamond. Next, Ben's cameo in the music video, Jenny from the Block. And then, the much-anticipated announcement of their engagement.
You're getting married.
Yes.
What's everyone's reaction, Ben? Are people happy for you?
I think people are happy. I think, you know, there's always going to be people who are kind of cynical and weird about things. But I think that's just the nature. I don't know. I don't care about stuff like that. But for the most part, people have been very, very kind of open and receptive and happy, I think.
Both the Lopez and Affleck families have been supportive of the couple. Ben's mom, Chris Affleck.
Somebody came to me and said, I read in the paper that you don't like Jennifer Lopez. And I said, what? You know, what is this about? But it did. It hurt because I thought, I don't want her to think this. You know, I mean, I want to get along with her. We're going to be family.
They're both on the same plane, on the same level. And I know he cares a lot about her. And they care about each other. So, and we always wish her the best. But I wish her, you know, I hope you have a lot of luck with this one.
Jennifer has spoken openly about the engagement. Now she talks candidly about walking down the aisle.
Every bride has wedding day jitters. Mm-hmm. What are you going to be nervous about on your wedding day?
I hope nothing, because I was nervous on the last two. That's fun.
Well,
I hope it feels really natural, or else I'm going to be worried. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, you're going to do it at the church this time, right?
Yes. I want to. And they're already trying to put little roadblocks up for me there, too. It's all right. I got it.
According to reports, those roadblocks include Jennifer's divorce from her first husband, Ohani Noah. That marriage must be annulled if Jennifer and Ben want to get married in a Catholic church. Her second divorce is not an issue since Jennifer and Chris Judd were married in an outdoor ceremony by her lawyer. No matter where the wedding happens, it's happening. But we wondered if there was any other news Jennifer might like to share.
Do you have a big announcement? A baby?
No? Did you hear that somewhere? Everywhere. No, unfortunately not. I wish.
Yeah. Do you think about that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Is that something you want?
Absolutely.
I definitely think that they're off to a really good start. I do. And I expect to be surrounded by mountains of grandchildren.
A family may be in the future, but for now, it's all about finding a balance between romance and careers.
We're going to have to compromise. I think we're really being conscious of each other's schedules and how we're going to do things. And it's going to be tough. It's going to be hard. And like I said, there's going to be compromise. But I think we'll work it out because we want to. And I think that's the most important thing, that you want to kind of work it out. It's not like, this relationship is taking up too much of my time. You know what I mean? It's not like that type of situation. We actually both want it to work.
Jen and Ben met while making the movie Geely. The couple enjoyed working together so much, they did it again, this time in the comedy Jersey Girl.
What's it like for you guys to work together, though?
Working together for me was a really great experience as it pertains to him, because I just didn't realize, I think, what a great actor he is, how professional he is, how kind of what a nice person he is to work with. You know what I mean? I think any actress who's ever worked with him would say the same thing. You know what I mean? He's incredibly generous and sweet and affectionate and just makes you feel really comfortable. So we had a great time working together. Plus, he loves to improv, which I do as well. So we played really well together and stuff like that. So in that sense, it was really great and a really pleasant thing to do.
But Ben's not Jennifer's only leading man. Jennifer stars in the romantic comedy Made in Manhattan with Ralph Fiennes.
Okay, I know you're used to getting what you want.
Well, until I met you.
At one point, Jennifer was even linked with Rafe.
We had went out to dinner one night. You know, we were done early. on the set, and me and my manager, and we invited him out, and some other people came with us, and we all sat down, and we were at this restaurant, and then, you know, the paparazzi came, and they took a picture of us, and then it was in the paper the next day that we were out, and was he my new boyfriend, or whatever, so.
Yeah.
What happens?
With Jennifer Lopez, it seems to happen quite a bit.
Are you your own worst critic?
Maybe not. No, I think I am very critical of myself, but I think there's plenty of people out there who criticize me as well.
You have so much self-confidence. Do you ever have any self-doubt?
Absolutely. Hell yeah. Just like anybody else, I have fear. I have a lot of fear about a lot of different things and a lot of insecurities. And, you know, I'm just like everybody else. But I think I do it in spite of it, despite it and in spite of it.
When was the last time you were really scared about something you were doing?
It's all the time, you know what I mean? I can't think of any one specific thing, but there's several different things, you know what I mean? Whether it's like knowing that I'm going to sing somewhere, you know, or doing a scene that I don't feel like I have a real grasp on or understand, or something in the writing, you know what I mean? It's different things, stuff like that, you know, when it comes to my work, and maybe because I am such a perfectionist, that scares me sometimes, but it's so funny because I'll know I'm terrified, you know what I mean? And people around me, I'll be like, I was so scared that day. And they were like, you were? You didn't seem scared. It's just like this thing where I just am like, I just have to go for it. I just have to do it. I'm not going to let the fear stop me.
Jennifer Lopez is an international icon, a media mogul whose success is unparalleled. She is known to the world simply as J-Lo, but Jennifer still sees herself as, well, Jenny from the block.
I'm still the same girl from the Bronx who used to take the train at Castle Hill, and Lupe's daughter, and David's daughter, and Linda's sister, and Leslie's sister, and used to sleep all in the same bed, and you know what I mean? And grew up in the Catholic school, and that's it, you know what I mean? And this is your job now. This is what you do, and you're lucky to do it, and you're happy to do it, and all that kind of stuff. And you're just thankful and grateful and come from a place of gratitude always, and that really helps as well. This I'm not wearing.
Come on, Julie. This is like Dalmatian pattern.
I didn't get my outfit.
Okay, I'm gonna get you an outfit.
Yeah.
It's a cow coat.
I have to wear this week.
This is what she gets to wear.
I can't live with this.
Yes.
I love it. Okay.
It's all about the coat.